So in the last class, we discussed about the respiration in organism. Did you remember that topic, respiration?
Yes, ma'am.
And what do you think? Does the respiration and the breathing, these two processes are same? Respiration and breathing? Yes. They are different, but they are interrelated. Respiration and breathing, both of them are two different processes, but they are interrelated. Then what is the difference between respiration and the breathing? Nivedita, what do you mean by respiration?
Respiration is the process of releasing energy from food.
It is the process of releasing energy from food. Very good. Then Herin, what do you mean by breathing?
The process of inhaling oxygen and releasing carbon dioxide.
Yes, the process of taking in the oxygen and the releasing out of carbon dioxide is known as breathing. Or we can say it is the exchange of gases using the respiratory organs. This is what is known as breathing. Okay. And in the last class, we were discussed about the cellular respiration. What do you mean by cellular respiration? Savio, are you there? Cellular respiration. Sandra, same question. Where is Savio, Sandra? He's running there. Savio, what do you mean by cellular respiration? Cellular respiration. I think some audio problem is there, right? Stina, cellular respiration. Again, the same question to Nivedita. What do you mean by cellular respiration?
Ma'am, the process of the breakdown of food in the cell with the release of energy.
Okay, the process of breaking down of food and thereby the releasing of energy is known as cellular respiration. And where this cellular respiration takes place?
In the cells of an organism.
It takes place inside the cells of an organism. Okay, very good. Then Herin, what do you mean by cell then? Cell. What do you mean by cell? Is it a new term? Cell. Cell is the basic structural unit of every organism. So if you are consider any organism, it is made up of a very small microscopic units. That small microscopic units are called cells. And what are the different functions of cells? Anyone? Different functions
nutrition,
of cell.
Nutrition,
digestion, transportation.
Very good. Very good. Nutrition, digestion, excretion, transportation. These are the different functions of the cell. In order to do these functions, our cell needs energy. And from where the cell get this energy in order to do all these functions?
From the breakdown of food.
From the breakdown of the food. Or we can simply say that if the cell requires all this energy, or cell requires energy for doing all these activities, and cell get this energy from the process of respiration. Okay. So today we are going to discuss about the two different types of respiration. Okay. And in the last class, we discussed that in order to break down the food, we need one type of gas. What's that?
Oxygen.
Oxygen is needed for the breakdown of the food into its simpler forms. And from where we get this oxygen?
By inhaling
or by the process of breathing. So in this way, the breathing and the respiration both are related to each other. Okay, so depending upon whether the oxygen is present during the time of breakdown of food or not, we can classify this cellular respiration into two. That is what we are going to discuss. Okay, so all of you please listen here. We have two types of cellular respiration. One is aerobic respiration and the other is anaerobic respiration. There are two types of respiration, aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. A-E-R-O-B-I-C, aerobic. Aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. So if the process of breakdown of the food takes place and thereby the releasing of energy, if this process is occurs inside the cells of an organism, we can call it as cellular respiration. There are two different types of cellular respirations are there. They are aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. So here we are going to discuss these two different types of respiration in detail. What about the first type of, what are the two different types of respiration? Cian, two different types of respiration?
Aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration.
Aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. And how we made this classification? Any idea how we made this classification of cellular respiration?
One respiration contains
Yes, it is classified depending upon whether the oxygen is present in the conversion or breakdown of food. Based on that, we have two different types of cellular respiration. If the breakdown of food takes place with the presence of oxygen, we can call it as aerobic respiration. Aerobic, aero. Aero means something that is related to air. Okay. So if the breakdown of food and the releasing of energy takes place with the presence of oxygen, we can call such type of cellular respiration as aerobic respiration. Then students, can you guess what do you mean by anaerobic respiration?
This respiration does not contain oxygen.
Yes, very good. The process in which the breakdown of food and the release of energy takes place without the presence of oxygen or in the absence of oxygen, we can call such type of respiration as anaerobic respiration. So let us see the definition for aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. As its name implies, aerobic respiration takes place in the presence of oxygen. Aerobic respiration is a cellular respiration which takes place in the presence of oxygen. Here you have the definition for aerobic respiration. All of you copy down the definition for aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration refers to the process of breakdown of food into carbon dioxide and water in the presence of oxygen. This is what is the definition for aerobic respiration. The process of breakdown of food and the release of energy is known as cellular respiration. But if the process of breakdown of food into carbon dioxide and water is occurs in the presence of oxygen, we can call such type of cellular respiration as aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration.
Ma'am, can you show the previous slide?
All right. Which one? This one?
No, ma'am, after this.
This
yeah,
one?
This one.
Okay. You only need to knock down the first point. It takes place in the presence of oxygen. Don't need to copy down the entire slide. This is for higher studies.
Okay, ma'am. Thanks.
Okay. Aerobic respiration is a process which takes place in the presence of oxygen.
Oxygen.
So here in this slide, you can get a clear definition for the aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration refers to the process of breakdown of food into carbon dioxide and water in the presence of oxygen. What happened to Adidev? Why are you Jane, late? Adi?
Yes, ma'am.
Why are you joining late?
Ma'am, I saw the message now.
All right. Okay. So, Adi, here we are discussing about the two types of cellular respiration. In the last class, we discussed about cellular respiration. Cellular respiration are basically classified into two, aerobic and anaerobic respiration. If the cellular respiration takes place in the presence of oxygen, we can call it as aerobic respiration. So, here we have an equation for aerobic respiration. That is glucose. Actually, we know that the food product after the digestion we obtained is nothing, it is glucose. This glucose is started to break down in the presence of oxygen. So here this glucose break down in the presence of oxygen. With the oxygen, it break down, and what are the products formed after this breakdown of glucose?
Carbon dioxide and water.
Carbon dioxide.
Very good. Carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide plus water plus one more thing. For what purpose this actually this food product are breakdown? In order to obtain the energy for the cell. So carbon dioxide plus water plus energy. Energy is released during this process. So by the process of the breakdown of glucose in the presence of oxygen, we get the products such as carbon dioxide, water and energy. Carbon dioxide plus water plus energy. This energy is utilized by the cells in order to do its, in order to performing various functions like nutrition, cell reproduction, excretion, transportation and all. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. So here glucose in the presence of oxygen converted to carbon dioxide, water and energy. The energy released in this aerobic respiration used by the cells for doing various functions. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we can discuss what you mean by anaerobic respiration. The next one is anaerobic respiration. So as we told earlier, it is a type of cellular respiration which takes place in the absence of oxygen. Okay, so without the presence of oxygen, the respiration is takes place inside the organism. Such type of respiration is known as anaerobic respiration.
Ma'am, this is aerobic respiration.
Okay, this is aerobic respiration. The next one is anaerobic. Sorry, anaerobic. Anaerobic respiration is a type of respiration that is the food is broken down into carbon dioxide and energy in the absence of oxygen. In the absence of oxygen. The respiration of the food is broken down into carbon dioxide and water and also in the form of energy in the absence of oxygen. We can call it as anaerobic respiration. And one more product is formed here along with this carbon dioxide. Instead of water, actually here the another product is formed, alcohol, not the water. Here the product formed is alcohol. Food broken down into carbon dioxide and energy in the absence of oxygen. For example, facultative anaerobes and obligate anaerobes. You don't need to be study about these two names, facultative and obligate. Instead of that, here the example is yeast. Yeast is an example for anaerobic respiration. Yeast. Have you heard about this yeast?
Yes, ma'am.
What is its use?
Ma'am.
What is its use?
It is mostly
used
for cooking.
Ah, yes, it's used for cooking processes. Okay, we are add the yeast for those in order to make appam and all for fluffing appearance and the yummy taste. So anaerobic respiration is a type of cellular respiration that is occurs inside the cell without the presence of oxygen or in the absence of oxygen. And what are the products formed after this reaction?
Carbon dioxide, alcohol and energy.
Very good. Carbon dioxide, alcohol and energy. So here glucose started to break down. Glucose in the absence of oxygen, absence of oxygen, glucose break down into carbon dioxide plus alcohol. Instead of water, here we get alcohol plus energy. So this is the major difference between aerobic and anaerobic. As its name implies, aerobic something that is related to the presence of oxygen. Respiration is takes place in the presence of oxygen. Anaerobic means respiration in the absence of oxygen. And the product that we are obtained after this aerobic and anaerobic respiration are different. What is the difference in the product that is formed after the aerobic and anaerobic respiration? What are the products that we are obtained in after aerobic?
Carbon dioxide, water and energy.
Very good. After aerobic respiration, we get carbon dioxide, water and energy. What about in the case of anaerobic respiration?
We get carbon dioxide, alcohol and energy.
Very good. We get carbon dioxide, alcohol and energy. Instead of water, here we obtained alcohol. And can you say one example for the anaerobic respiration?
Yeast.
Yeast is one example. Yes?
Ma'am, is there any example for aerobic respiration?
Yeah, obviously. What about our human beings? Human beings are actually follows aerobic respiration. Okay. Human beings and most of all the organisms are possess aerobic respiration. That is the process of breakdown of food is takes place in the presence of oxygen. That is what is known as aerobic respiration. Human beings and other organisms. Okay. Okay, so here in this case, aerobic respiration, as we told earlier, it is a type of respiration in which oxygen is present for the breakdown of the food, and what happens as a result, we get the two products, that is carbon dioxide, water and energy, and this energy is taken by the cells in order to carry out its different functions. Okay, so for example in human beings, aerobic respiration takes place because we are breathe air. Through this inhalation process, we get oxygen, and this oxygen is used for the breakdown of the food. As a result, the glucose breakdown into carbon dioxide, water, and energy. This energy utilized by the different cells in order to perform its various function. So whenever we talk about the cells, you must have an idea about what you mean by cell. What is cell? We discussed about the cell in the first chapter. What do you mean by cell? These are the
cell is a tiny microscopic unit present in all organisms.
Yes, these are the basic structural units of all organism, or these are the tiny microscopic units which are used to make the body of all the organisms are made with this tiny microscopic units called a cell. All right. And here we discuss about the aerobic respiration. Here you can see glucose. Inside the cell, the breakdown of this glucose takes place in the presence of oxygen, and which is converted into carbon dioxide, water and energy. This energy is utilized by our body in order to do various functions. Okay. The next anaerobic respiration, as its name implies, it is a respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen. After that, the glucose is converted into carbon dioxide, alcohol and energy. One example for the anaerobic respiration is yeast. Okay, so here you can see the microscopic view of yeast. Okay, so what is the speciality of yeast? Yeast is actually single-celled organism. Yeast is single-celled organisms. And inside the yeast, which type of respiration takes place?
Anaerobic respiration.
Anaerobic respiration takes place. And what are the products formed after this anaerobic respiration?
Carbon dioxide, alcohol and energy.
Carbon dioxide, alcohol and energy. That is why the yeast is mainly used for the preparation of beers, beer and wine or alcohol. Okay, so while some houses, they are used to make the wines. So if you are observe, you can find that your mom sometimes add this yeast in this wine, because in the case of yeast, anaerobic respiration is takes place. It convert the glucose. We know that what are the components, which are the different components we are add while preparing the wine, grape wine or any other kind of wine. That particular, for example, if it is a grape, we are add grape and sugar content is added. Along with that, the yeast is also added. For what? Because yeast convert the glucose present in the sugar into carbon dioxide, alcohol, and also some kind of energy is released. Okay. So it is the yeast which is responsible for the conversion of grape into grape wine. It converted it into a form of alcohol. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So respiration in yeast. This is the yeast that we are used to buy from shops. Yeast are eukaryotic. Eukaryotic means single-celled microorganism. It belongs to fungus kingdom. You don't need to be study about this. Only need to study yeast are single-celled microorganisms. Yeasts are single-celled microorganisms. They are used for several purposes in the food and beverage industry. Beverage industry means it is used to make the beer, wine and alcohols like that. They are used in bakery industry. Brewer's yeast is used in beer fermentation and in wine fermentation. They are capable of surviving even in the absence of air, and hence they are termed as anaerobes. Yeast are also known as anaerobes. Okay, because we can survive even in the absence of oxygen, and they carry out anaerobic respiration. Such type of organisms are called anaerobes. So we can say yeasts are called anaerobes. Since they can survive in the absence of air, they can even break down the glucose into alcohol, carbon dioxide and energy in the absence of oxygen, and hence undergoes the anaerobic respiration. Okay, so yeast are single-celled organism. It can survive in the absence of what? It can survive in the absence of? Yeast can survive in the absence
oxygen.
Of?
Oxygen.
Very good. Yeast can survive in the absence of oxygen. It can survive. These are the different characteristics of yeast. Single-celled organism, survive in the absence of oxygen. That is why yeast are also known as
anaerobes.
Very good. Therefore, the yeast are also called anaerobes. Okay, and what are the different uses of yeast? They are used for
making beverages.
Yes, they are used for several purposes in the food. Okay, for different purposes of food. Different purposes of food and beverage industry. Okay. And it undergoes which type of respiration? Aerobic respiration or anaerobic respiration?
Anaerobic respiration.
It undergoes anaerobic respiration. All right. So these are some summary of this entire slide. Respiration in yeast is a type of anaerobe because it can survive in the absence of oxygen. So it undergoes anaerobic respiration. It used for food purposes and also in the beverage industry. Okay. And in some special cases, in our human beings, our muscles are also respire anaerobically. That is what is we are going to discuss next. Okay, so here we say one example for the anaerobic respiration, that is yeast. Yeast is an anaerobe. So it undergoes anaerobic respiration. Similarly, In case of human beings are comes under the category of aerobic respiration or anaerobic respiration?
Aerobic respiration.
Okay, we are human beings are normally comes under the category of aerobic respiration. But in some situations or some special cases, our muscles, the muscles are comes or it is respire anaerobically. Can you say the, what are the different cases at which the muscles are respire anaerobically? After cycling, jumping, running, or heavy weight lifting, what did you feel, students?
Ma'am, our legs feel pain.
Yeah, sometimes our legs feel pain, our muscle pain occurs and all, and we are become so tired, right?
Yes. Okay. Ma'am.
So during that stress, our cell possesses a lack of oxygen. So there will be an absence of oxygen is opposed to the muscle. During such a situations, our muscles respire anaerobically. So after cycling, running, jumping, or heavy weightlifting, what happens? There will be a lack of oxygen should be there in the cells. So during that times, for doing these kind of performing these kind of activities, our cells started to respire anaerobically. So here we are going to write the reaction that is takes place during that time. So, in the absence of oxygen, our muscles are respire anaerobically. During that time, glucose in the absence of oxygen converted to, in the absence of oxygen, the glucose converted to lactic acid plus no alcohol, energy. Alcohol product is formed only in the anaerobic respiration that is mainly occurs in the case of yeast. But here, in the case of muscles, in some special cases like heavy running, heavy weightlifting or jumping, our muscles are formed some kind of muscle cramps or muscle pains are occurs. It is mainly because during that time, the muscles respire anaerobically. So during this time, glucose in the absence of oxygen, they converted into lactic acid and energy. Okay, so when the muscles respire anaerobically, here the product formed are lactic acid and energy. Energy is released during this process and it occurs for a very short interval of period, short period of time. Not for the all day and for a long period. This respiration of the muscles in the absence of oxygen is takes place for a very short period of time. So during this process, we get lactic acid. Okay. So the excess accumulation of the lactic acid in the muscles causes this muscle cramps or muscle pain. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so actually the accumulation of the lactic acid is the responsible for the muscle cramps and muscle pains. And sometimes we may be observed that whenever after this, we get a short relief. We get a relief from this muscle cramps or muscle pains. Then when we are making a hot water bath or massage. Okay, so how we get this relief from this muscle cramps after this hot water bath and massaging?
Because it won't lack oxygen.
Yes. So during this hot water bath or that of the massaging, what actually happens, the circulation of blood increases. Okay. Circulation of blood increases. So along with that, it carries the oxygen, the sufficient amount of oxygen. Then what happens? Our cells started to respire aerobically. That is glucose in the presence of oxygen. The breakdown of the food occurs and it converts into carbon dioxide, water and energy. Instead of lactic acid, it completely converts the glucose into the carbon dioxide, water and energy. Okay, so this is why after the hot water bath or that of the massage, we get a relief from that of the muscle cramps or muscle pains. Okay, Adidev, I will share the screen. So this is the reaction of anaerobic respiration of muscles. Anaerobic respiration of muscles. So in the absence of oxygen, our muscles respire anaerobically. During this time, glucose converted to lactic acid and energy, and the accumulation of lactic acid in the muscle responsible for the muscle cramps or muscle pains.
Ma'am, finished.
Okay. What about others?
Yes, ma'am, finished.
Yes, ma'am.
So now our next topic is actually breathing. We are already told about breathing from the initial class. So can you recall what you mean by breathing? So here you can see the muscle cramps, how it is occurs. Reason for muscle cramps. The reason for muscle cramps is actually because of the anaerobic respiration of the muscle. This leads to the partial breakdown of the glucose into lactic acid. This lactic acid gets accumulated. It is accumulated in the body, consequently leading to muscle cramps. Consequently leading to muscle cramps. Hot water bath or a massage improves circulation of blood, thereby increasing the supply of oxygen to the muscle cells. This sufficient supply of oxygen to the cells results in the complete breakdown of lactic acid into carbon dioxide and water, thereby giving you relief. Okay, so here the glucose in the absence of oxygen get converted into lactic acid and energy. This lactic acid is accumulated in the muscles. It causes the muscle cramp or the muscle pain. After the hot water bath or the massage, the sufficient supply of oxygen takes place with the circulation of blood. So thereby we get a relief from this muscle cramps. Is it over?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then once again, what do you mean by breathing? Breathing.
Breathing is the process of inhaling oxygen and exhaling carbon dioxide.
The process of exchanging gases.
Yes, the process of exchanging gases is with the help of whom? With the help of respiratory organs. Respiratory. We will discuss about these respiratory organs in the next session. When we are started about the respiration in organism, we will discuss about the different types of respiratory organs and all. So the process of exchanging gases with the help of respiratory organs is known as breathing. Okay. Or we can say it is the process of taking in of the air, which is rich in oxygen, and the process of releasing out of air, which is rich in
carbon dioxide.
Very good. Excellent. Carbon dioxide. This is what is known as breathing. Okay. And during process, we take the oxygen inside. This process is known as Nivedita.
Can you repeat?
The process in which the oxygen is taken in by the body, taken inside to the body is known as inhalation. And the process of giving out of carbon dioxide is known as
exhalation.
Very good. Excellent. It is known as exhalation. Okay. So we will discuss about this breathing rate in the next class. So once again, we can summarize all the points that we were discussed today. So what are the two different types of cellular respiration?
Aerobic and anaerobic respiration.
Adide, what do you mean by aerobic? Yes, Harin, what do you mean by aerobic respiration?
It takes place in the presence of oxygen. Hmm. Aerobic respiration refers to the process of breakdown of food into carbon dioxide, water, and
what is the major form of product from energy? Very good. Then Nivedita,
defined anaerobic.
Adi, Nivedita, anaerobic respiration.
Ma'am, in the process of the respiration in which the food is broken down into carbon dioxide and the energy is survived in the absence of oxygen.
Okay, Abhinav, can you say one example for the anaerobic respiration? Anaerox? Yeast. Yeast is one example for the anaerobes or anaerobic respiration. Okay, that's all for